us see the property of circular convolution. We know that for a given sequences, the multiplication of the two DFTs is equivalent to the circular convolution of their sequences in the time domain. That is, if one sequence is x1 of n and its corresponding DFT is x1 of k, and another sequence x2 of n and its corresponding DFT is given by the x2 of k. Now, the multiplication of these two DFTs is equivalent to the circular convolution of x1 of n and x2 of n. Let us see how to determine the circular convolution of the given sequence. So, first of all, we have to follow the first step, that is to determine the length of sequence, that is capital N, and we have to use the value of M, which is starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to N minus 1. Secondly, let us define mathematically the circular convolution. So, it is defined as y of n is equal to summation from n is equal to 0 up to n minus 1 x of n into h of m minus n. Let us substitute the value of different m and n in the given equation of the circular convolution. For example, if we substitute the value of m is equal to 0, then the equation becomes y of 0 is equal to summation from n is equal to 0 up to 3 x of n h of minus n. Here this equation indicates that the multiplication of the x of n and h of minus n. Now here h of minus n, that is nothing but the circularly folded sequence of h of n. In next step, we have to draw the two concentric circles where x of n is the inner circle and h of minus n, that is the outer circle. Here we have drawn x of n as an inner circle and h of minus n as an outer circle. Here we have to note that the samples of x of n, it is written along the anticlockwise direction, while the samples of h of n that are plotted along the clockwise direction. So, the outer circle, that is nothing but the folded version of h of n. Now, we have to do the individual multiplication and addition. That will give us the convolution of x of n and h of n. So, here we are multiplying the first samples, that is x of 0 into h of 0. Then we have to add it with the x of 1 h of 3 plus x of 2 h of 2 plus x of 3 into h of 1. When we substitute the value of m, we will get the second circular convolution over here. So, y of n, here we will see that here the h of n, it has been shifted by the one sample over here. So, the outer circle which is indicating h of n, we are shifting it by the one sample, and again following the same step of the addition and multiplication, that is the x of 0 h of 1 x of 1 h of 0 x of 2 h of 3 plus x of 3 h of 2, which will give us the convolution, next convolution sample. When we substitute the value of m, that is equal to 2, again here the h of n, we have to delay it by the two samples over here. So, you will see that the value of h of 0, that has been shifted by the two samples from its origin, and again follow the same steps of the multiplication and addition, which gives us another one sample of the convolution. Let us take a simple example to compute the circular convolution of the sequence x of n having the samples of 0, 1, 2, 3 and h of n having the samples of 2, 1 and 2, 1. In first step, we have to determine the length of the sequence. Now, we calculate the total number of samples in x of n, that is equal to the 4. So, capital N, it indicates the total number of samples in x of n. In few cases, the two sequences, they are not having the same length. In such a case, we have to append few zeros so that these two sequences becomes of the equal length. This process is known as the zero padding. After that, we have to plot the sequences x of n and h of n circularly anticlockwise. We are having this equation of the circular convolution. Let us substitute the value of m, which is starting from 0, 1, 2, up to 3. Here the m is starting from 0 up to n minus 1. So n's value, that is equal to 4. So that's why the m becomes from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1, that is the 4 minus 1. So the last value of m, that will be equal to the 3. Let us draw these two circles over here. X of n, we are plotting this sequence. Here the samples of this sequence x of n, we are plotting along the clock anticlockwise direction. While h of n, again we are plotting these samples along the anticlockwise direction. Now let us substitute the different values of n and m in the given equation of the circular convolution. So starting from m is equal to 0, the equation becomes y of 0 is equal to summation from n is equal to 0 up to 3 x of n into h of minus n. This equation indicates that we have to do the multiplication between the x of n and h of minus n. So h of minus n, that is nothing but the circularly folded sequence. Next step we have to follow to draw the two concentric circles of x of n as an inner circle and h of minus n as an outer circle. So we are plotting the sequences along these circles. So x of n, it is the inner circle. We are plotting all the samples in the anticlockwise direction, while the h of n, that is the outer circle, we are plotting h of minus n over here, so that all the samples are plotted over here along the clockwise direction. Now let us do the multiplication and addition process. So here x of 0 multiplied by h of 0 plus x1 of 1 h of 3 plus x of 2 h of 2 plus x of 3 h of 1. So here we are doing the corresponding multiplication and addition. The value it is shown over here, that is equal to the 7. So that is nothing but the first sample of the circularly convolved sequence. In next step, let us substitute the value of m, that is equal to 1. When we substitute this value, you will find that here the h sequence, it has been delayed by the sample 1. So again we have to shift this h of n in anticlockwise direction by one sample. So again we have to follow the same procedure of the multiplication and addition over here. So after doing the multiplication and addition of the corresponding samples of x of n and h of n, here we are getting the second convolved value of these two sequences, that is equal to 9. Next is we have to follow, that is m is equal to 2. And again here you will see that the h of n, we have to delay it by the two samples. When we do that, again we have to plot that along this outer circle, and let us do the multiplication and addition procedure. So after that further calculation, we will find that this value, that is equal to 11. When we substitute value is equal to 3 of the m, again we are plotting the sequence along the circular axis. Outer circle is the h of n, inner circle is the x of n, and here we are doing the corresponding multiplication, and final value of this convolution we are getting it as a 9. So let us summarize all these values over here. So y of m, that indicates the 7, 9, 11, 9, which is nothing but the circular convolution between x of n and h of n. So that is for the